नमस्कार लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इट इज माय प्लेजेंट ड्यूटी टू प्रेजेंट ऑन टॉपिक एडवांसेस इन इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ बिल्डिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन टेक्नोलॉजीज ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ इंडिया कंस्ट्रक्शन वीक 2020. एज यू आर ऑल अवेयर दैट आवर कंट्री इज वेरी लार्ज, सफरिंग लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स एंड हाउसिंग इज वन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम which is being faced by the people of India. To address this particular problem, Government of India has launched a very ambitious program on National Mission Housing for All to provide a safe, sustainable, economical, durable housing for the people of the country. When we look at that with the current or traditional construction technologies which are being practiced in vogue, it is very difficult to meet out this particular target by 2022. And this is the platform wherein we can set a roadmap to introduce the new technologies, emerging technologies, to meet out this particular demand through technological interventions. With this big background, the outline of my presentation would be as shown in this particular slide. And for this purpose, we will be focusing on advanced construction technologies, emerging technologies in majority of the housing projects. Whenever we look into the technologies, those technologies should be safe, sustainable, economical, faster, as well as they should be multi-hazard resilient, and important thing is it should be acceptable to the society as a whole. To meet the aspiration of the society, one has to understand the need of the user first, and for that purpose all the stakeholders has to come together and find out the different approaches to meet out the common objectives of people of the country. And for that purpose, when we look at it with the traditional technologies, definitely that will not meet out the target, and for that purpose we need to take a help of technological interventions, innovative emerging technologies. And when we look the globally, the different levels of construction technologies that is being ranging from level 0 to level 4. Level 0 basically is a material centric technologies, and 90% of existing construction happening in our country is on level 0, whereas level 1, 2 and 3 focuses on component level, element level or volumetric system level, whereas level 4 is on the complete building system. In our country, as I mentioned, that 90% is on level 0 and hardly 10% is on level 1 and 2. We are yet to reach on level 3 and 4. Maybe 10 years down the line, if we all technical people work hard, we can achieve the target. But at the moment, our target is to reverse the ratio, that we need to increase the volume of precast construction technologies in day-to-day construction life, so that this 90:10 can be reversed to 10:90. In past, several attempts have been made by different researchers, industries, to come out or bring the technologies on a component level. CESIR, CBRI has also contributed to a large extent since last 3 to 4 decades on component level developments. Some of the developments are shown on this particular slides. Now, in order to give the speed up the process, mechanization has also been intervened in between. And during this process, we try to understand the various impediments being faced in day-to-day construction processes. One of the examples, like the development of headed bars as a mechanical anchorage system for beam column joints, has been evolved after understanding the problems in the building constructions, specifically on beam column joints. The problems majorly depends on the steel congestion, casting difficulties, improper compaction, honeycombing, and which is basically leading to weak beam column joints, and which is problematic things, specifically when it is subjected to an earthquake shaking. After conducting rigorous experimental investigation design, we have come out with this particular technology, and now this technology is also embedded within Indian standards. Likewise, we have to make different attempts so that our technologies go a long way and we can incorporate certain innovation in our day-to-day construction activities. Now it is high time to move from component level to system level to achieve the targeted objectives. Another stepping stone made by the CSIR CBRI is on the construction technology demonstration park, wherein the attempts have been made to bring back all the technologies on a single platform. And basically, this particular park is a fusion of construction technologies that offers a wide choice of options to the industry, academia, researcher for mass housing projects under different sets of geoclimatic conditions. The park currently showcases two-storied houses having a square 1,100 square feet covered area. And this banquet of technology demonstrates a wide range of technology, right from traditional technologies, bamboo housing, to the advanced technologies like 3D concrete printing, and including the precast construction technology or industrial buildings. These technologies are not only simply demonstrated here, but they are subjected to a rigorous evaluation of watertightness under cloudburst scenario, acoustic, thermal, indoor, outdoor air quality monitoring, performance under different axial load, fire, and many more such tests which are needed from safety, durability, and comfort point of view. So these are the different technologies which are being which have been demonstrated in the technology parks, and the different functionality tests which are being performed on each typology. Most of the times we came complaint kind of, people are complaining that about the water tightness, leakages, seepages majorly happening in the prefabricated constructions. To address this particular common complaint, we have conducted extensive water tightness tests on these buildings. Firstly, by means of a bonding, and followed by creating or simulating the cloudburst scenario on this building. In this cloudburst scenario, while doing such tests, we have taken the thermal imaging before, during, and after the event has occurred. And then after the superimposing all kinds of image, that will give us a way out how to identify or what are the difficult or typical positions or locations where the ingress of moisture is being taking place. For creating a cloudburst scenario, we have created a rainfall precipitation at the rate of 230 mm per hour continuously for 5 hours by experimental demonstration, as you have seen in the movie, and thereby identifying the locations of weaknesses and find out the what is the cause and what are the solutions to address this kind of a problem. So this is how we have conducted the water tightness test by means of a cloudburst scenario in construction technology demonstration park in one of the construction advanced technology, that is on 3S industrialized precast building systems. Likewise, we have also attempted to conduct rigorous instrumentation on each buildings by placing around 250 sensors on each buildings, which are responsible for taking the data 24/7 throughout the year related to thermal, acoustic, noise, air quality, so on and so forth, by making use of IoT-enabled real-time monitoring system. And the data thus collected is compiled together, analyzed, and this is the for different type of buildings. And this is the slides which shows the ensemble of data and its comparison being taken place from temperature, humidity, noise, indoor outdoor air quality monitoring, even the RF signals for different type of building technology. Basically, by doing so, we are leading or we are calculating the thermal performance index, which is the basically guiding factor for us for selection of appropriate and optimal technology for different geoclimatic conditions across our country. The objective of this particular demonstration park is not only simple demonstration, but also it is creating awareness and evaluation of different kind of technologies. And at the same time, it is creating a technical data bank for of various existing alternate construction materials, construction technologies, which are time-tested, proven, and can really be deployed on the field based on the geoclimatic condition. It also helps in development of test protocols. In the end, our aim is to meet the aspiration of the people of the India from the construction industry, and it is expected that more and more technologies will be added as and when developed and verified in near future. The important test which is being conducted on these technologies is on the axial test and lateral test on a full scale level, and that has been successfully done at CSIR CBRI on one of the very promising technology that is called as a 3S building systems, which is a precast construction technologies launched by BG Shirke Construction Technology Private Limited. So everybody, most of the people are aware about this technology. This technology is having its own advantages, which is fast, durable, and we are getting very good quality control, cost effective, sustainable, so and so forth, because all the activities are being done under strict quality control and in a very systematic manner. But now there was a question, how this particular technology detailing has been done and how this technology is sustainable from different loading point of view, particularly the axial load and lateral load. So during the evolution of this particular technologies in last two decades, it has gone into tests on the component level, full scale level on a building when it is subjected to axial loads. And at CBRI, we have conducted a test on a full-scale level when the building was subjected to simulated earthquake conditions scenario by conducting quasi-static test, in which incremental increase in displacement control loading was applied at different floor level. The response of the building was collected by means of sensors located at critical locations. Data acquisition system was deployed to capture the data, and subsequently, after that, during the conducting the test, the damage occurring on various critical locations have been observed, and which were the guiding factor for further improvement in the technology. The data thus collected was utilized for development of a hysteresis loop, thereby assessing the seismic performance in terms of strength, stiffness, ductility, energy dissipation capacity, and deformability. Based on that, important one of the parameter that the response reduction factor, that is behavior factor, has been emerged out, which is a very important factor which is being used for the design purpose during the design stage. So this is how we have conducted the test, and after, based on the test result, the joints detailing have been perfected, and now the system is successfully being implemented at different locations on the field across the country. At the same time, we are focusing on the advanced construction technology, but my focus of this presentation was that whatever the emerging technologies we are dedicating for the service of the people of this country, they should pass through all similar kind of tests, so that when we hand over these technologies to the common man, then they should not come with the problems, but they should appreciate that appreciation will be the appreciation of entire construction industry. In summary, I would like to conclude that the prefabricated buildings for housing is a promising construction technologies for particularly for the mass housing, should be multi-hazard resistant proven technology. Presently, The component level focus was there. Now it has to be shifted from component level to the system level. There are various range of technologies available. Now it is time for us to take this technology from lab to land, definitely through R&D collaboration between industry and the academy. At the same time, we need to think forward and invest more on R&D to innovate new technologies, because in last 3 to 4 decades, we have focused enormously on automation, quality innovations. Now we have to couple these premises along with the safety and come out with the robust technology for the people of the country. At the same time, we need to focus on increasing the technical competence, which is basically again integrating the attitude, skill and knowledge of entire each one of us in the construction industry. If we attempt to do so, then real success of this particular conference, this particular week, will be evolved, and we can give a good future for the next generation. With this, ladies and gentlemen, I am thankful to you for your kind attention and patience in hearing. Thank you.